object in a sentence, and one new thing called phrasal verbs. Have you heard about phrasal verbs? And we decided about phrasal verbs also in this chapter. And I know that you are familiar with nouns. You have studied all those things in your previous class, right? So anyway, we can just go through this again. Listen, what do you mean by noun? Nouns are names, right? Names of animals, people, things, and places. You know that, right? So for all together, for all the names, we'll be calling them as nouns. And here comes the first category of noun. Proper noun. So what do you mean by proper noun? A proper noun is specially given to a particular person, place, or thing. Okay, we know that. We'll be calling persons with different names, right? Manjusha, Aman, Mazam, Devika. Then for places, Calicut, India. Things also will be there. Table, chair, right? So can be called as proper nouns. And most probably we'll be using capital letters for writing proper nouns, for writing names and places, and not even using capital letters, right? And then comes collective nouns. So collective noun was a special name for a group of people, animals, or things of the same kind. So for a collective, for a group, okay? So for a group, we'll be giving some particular names. For a group of people, we'll be called crowd. Okay? For flowers, we'll be calling as bouquet of flowers. Okay? Bunch of banana. Like that, we have some particular names. So such names are known as collective nouns. Okay? And then comes another item, abstract noun. Okay? An abstract noun is a name given to a quality, an idea, or a condition, not a thing. So abstract noun is somewhat different. It's not any person, it's not a thing, it's not a place, something like that. It's a condition or an idea. Okay, surprise. So let's try now. Okay, like that, some other thing will be coming that we cannot go and touch, we cannot see those things. Okay, so that is what is an extract noun. Then comes another term called countable nouns and uncountable nouns also. So countable nouns mean something that we can count. Okay, so we can count and find out how many numbers are there. Such nouns can be called as countable nouns, and there are some nouns that we cannot count and find out the number, so that is called uncountable noun. So these are the items that we have in our textbook, and there are some activities also, activity A and activity B. These two activities are there for you to work out, and I need you all to do that activities in your textbook itself and use your pencils to write all the answers. Okay? It will be difficult if you use a pen to write in your textbook. If you want to rub or cut an answer, attempt any wrong answer or like that, it will be good if you use a pencil to write in your textbook. Okay? So I need you all to do it, and I'll be passing the answers for you to check out in your groups. Okay, fine? So now, other thing was there, I told you, like we have some other thing called subject and object. Okay, so subject, what is subject? We are familiar with so many subjects, right? English is a subject, maths, science, social, so many subjects are there. So we are not talking about that subject here. Okay, so we are talking about some other subject. So you want to see what is it? So this subject. And we'll be talking about one more thing called object. Okay, so for studying what is a subject and what is an object, let's write a sentence here. Okay, well, by using that sentence, we can find out what's a subject and what's an object. Okay, so listen, she is reading a book subject means the doer of the action in a sentence. If there will be a person or an animal in a sentence to do the action of it. Here the action of reading, right? So, who is reading? She is reading. And what is she reading? She is reading a book. Okay? So, here the doer of the action is called subject. Okay? And something will be there in the sentence to receive the action. So, here it is the book which receives the action. Okay? So, she or the subject will give us the answer for who. Who is reading? She is reading. So, it is considered as the subject. And what does reading? A book. So, it will give us the answer for what. Okay. Object. Okay. So, she is the subject here and a book is the object here. Is it clear for you? So, she, the doer of the action and sentence is called the subject. The person, who? The person or animal. Sometimes animals also need to be there in a sentence, right? So, at that time, the person, the animal who is doing the action and sentence is called the subject of the sentence. And sometimes there will be something at the end of the sentence, okay, to receive the action. So, that thing can be called. It might be a thing, it might be a person, okay? So, that thing or person which receives the action is known as the object, okay? And most probably, we can tell that the subject will come at the beginning of the sentence just before the verb, the activity. Here the action or the activity is reading. So, the subject will come just before the action. And object will come after the action, action or verb. Okay, so that was it. Is it clear for you? Okay, so here it is, subject and object. Subject is the person or the thing who do the action, and object is the thing or person who receives the action. Clear? Is it okay for you? I think it is okay. Right? And we have one more thing to study in this chapter called the phrasal verbs. Okay? Have you heard about phrasal verbs? Phrasal verbs. Have you heard about this one? It's a new item, right? So, phrasal verbs. A phrasal verb will contain two words. Okay? And for example, I can give you put out. Two words are there, right? Put out. And both these words has got different meanings also. Put has got a meaning, out has got also a meaning. So when they come together, they will form some other meaning that we will not think at all. Okay, so this is a verb and this is a preposition. You have studied prepositions, right? In your food standard, you have studied about so many prepositions, right? So, a phrasal verb is a mixture of a verb and a preposition. Okay, so many words will come like this, so many phrasal verbs will come like this, put out, put off, put in. Across. And when they are standing apart, they will have different meaning and they will come together, they will come with some other different meaning. Okay, so there is some activity related to this phrasal verbs also in your textbook. And here you have got so many phrasal verbs. Starts with game. Start with give in, give away, give back, give off, give out, give up, readings also are there in your textbook. So we can discuss about that one also now. Okay, and it is given here like this: verb plus preposition. Okay, so phrasal verbs will have a verb and a preposition, and together they will form some other meaning. Okay, so I hope it is clear for you all, and I need you all to do the activities related to all the grammar sections that we discussed now. Okay, do all the activities in your textbook. Keep it with you. I will provide you the answers also. Okay, to check. Okay, so we can meet with the next video. Thank you all.